Load shedding, traveling, you need a power bank to keep you up. Upshade, this is SKMDK, back with another video. So, welcome to the first edition of the Tech Under 1K monthly series, where I try to show you cool and useful tech that won't break the bank. So, for the first edition, what do we have? Yes, we have the LT T20 PS Plus power bank. You'll recall that I did an unboxing of it some time ago, linked over here. So, after using it for around 3 weeks, I think I'm ready to actually give you a review on it. So, without wasting any time, let's get right into this. Let's start with the design of it. I think it has quite a nice, neat and minimalistic design. One thing I really like is the inclusion of the LED display, giving you the amount of charge and the capacity that you have on your power bank. I'm really a fan of this compared to the other power banks with the dotted light setup, which makes it a bit difficult to tell how much capacity is still left on your power bank. We should recall that this power bank is actually a 20,000 milliamp hour power bank, which means that it's quite huge and it can be felt by its heaviness. It measures around 431 grams to be exact. However, I have to say, it's not that heavy that one cannot carry it around. There are multiple different ports on the top side of the power bank. Onto your left is really where there's the input ports, where you can charge your power bank. The first one being a standard USB connector, micro USB connector, and then secondly, a lightning connector for your sort of Apple charging. The ports on the right are really for the output charge. And then there's the middle port, which is a USB Type-C port. This is a special one, mainly because of the fact that it actually works also as an input as well as an output. So meaning that actually we have three output ports as well as three input ports. So three ways of charging the power bank as well as three ways of charging other devices. You think that's enough to make it come out on top during load shedding? The middle USB Type-C port also supports fast charging. Well, speaking of fast charging, let's jump into the charging speeds on this power bank. Let's look at the speed of charging the power bank itself. I tested with the Samsung super fast charger, as well as the normal fast charging charger, as well as then the micro USB charger, which is sort of a slow charger. And the results are as follows. With the slow charger, it actually took 24 hours to charge. Now that's really a long time. But thankfully, the power bank also supports fast charging itself, albeit at 18 watts. And this can be seen by the fact that when I use a super fast charger or the normal fast charger, the charging speeds were similar, coming in at around 6 hours and 25 minutes, which I think is actually great. Now, looking at the experience of charging other devices, the downside of this power bank is the fact that it doesn't support wireless charging, which for me is not really a deal breaker. Depending on the port you connect to, this will be a fast or slow charge. In terms of the charging speed, that will depend on the capacity of your device. When I checked with my Galaxy Z Fold 2 5G, which has a capacity of 4,500 mAh, it took close to 2 hours, which I think is still good. Now this brings us to the special feature of this power bank, which is what is called free charge technology. Basically what this means, it means the power bank is able to adjust optimally the charge that is sent to the other device based on the charging requirements of the other device. So if the device supports fast charging, then the power bank will optimally adjust the charge for fast charging. If it doesn't, then it will just put it as slow charging. Now this is great because then you're not worried about whether the right amount of charge is sent to the other device. While on this note, let us look at the different ports on the power bank in more detail. The ports supporting free charge technology are marked with a FIT symbol. Now, understanding how free charge technology works means that these are the ports that are also able to adjust the charge optimally for fast charging. This is with the middle two-way USB Type-C port, as well as the other normal USB port. Interesting enough is when I charge with my Galaxy Z Fold 2 5G, the fast charging is only supported when I use the two-way middle USB Type-C port. If I use the other normal USB port, which supports free charge, my device still charges at a slow speed. Now this is interesting because of the fact that when I use it with my Galaxy Note 8, then whether I use a two-way middle USB Type-C port or the other normal USB port with free charge, it still charges at fast charging. probably something that has to do with my Galaxy Z Fold 2. Speaking of different charges, when you press the power button on the power bank, the first time it gives you the capacitor on the power bank. And then you also see a blue Fit Charge icon if Fit Charge technology is activated, meaning it's also on fast charging mode. When you press the power button again, it will give you the current voltage reading. Pressing it again then gives you the ampere reading. I guess this is just for nerds. I also wanted to test if I can charge multiple devices at once. This is possible, except the fact that I noticed that when I do that, then fast charging stops and all the ports seem to revert to slow charging. I also want to test if indeed this power bank is a 20,000 mAh capacity. I charge the power bank to full capacity and then I try to charge my two devices, the Galaxy Note 8, which is a 3,500 mAh capacity, as well as my Galaxy Z Fold 2, which is a 4,500 mAh capacity, and check the results. And these are the results. I managed to charge my Galaxy Note 8 once from 0 to 100. Also managed to charge my Galaxy Z Fold 2 5G once from 0 to 100. And then I charged the Z Fold 2 again from 0 to 72%. And then again from 8 to 40%. At which point the power bank was then depleted. So if you do the math, you'll notice that this takes us to a capacity of 12,680 mAh, which is not quite the promised 20,000 mAh. Though I do believe that this was also not a fair test because of the fact that with some of the charges, I was actually also using my devices. So probably a fair test would be me switching off my devices and then just charging them. I will do this test and give an update on the comment box on whether it indeed gets us to 20,000 mAh. Now this brings us to the final section of this review, which can be a decider on whether this is the power bank for you or not, which is the price. Now this comes in at 650 Rand on Take A Lot. And for my non-South African viewers, at the time of recording this video, I noticed that the power bank is currently out of stock on Amazon. But if we were to do a rough comparison or a rough conversion of the price, it would be around $43.80. I'll make sure I include the link to Take A Lot as well as the link to the Amazon product. So if you ask me if this power bank will help you come out on top during load shedding and show load shedding moves boss, I would say yes. Because of the bigger capacity of the power bank, meaning that you can charge multiple devices at once, and also the fast charging technology, as well as the Fit Charge technology, which is then great because then even during load shedding, I can make sure that I charge my devices very quickly. But anyway, please let me know in the comment section whether you think this is ideal for load shedding as well as traveling, or whether you think this power bank is something that you would consider getting. And also, if you like this video, please smash on that like button and also consider subscribing. This really goes a long way in supporting me as a YouTuber. Now, until then, keep well and see you in the next video. And don't forget to come back after a month for another edition of Tech Under 1K. Cheers.